You know, yesterday we spent some time in our devotional thinking about the first phrase of what Jesus taught us to pray. It says at the very beginning, "Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name." And we spent some time yesterday thinking about what it means to say God is our Father in heaven. But today I want to think about that second phrase, what it means to say hallowed be your name. In Ecclesiastes 5:2, it says this, "God is in heaven and you're on earth, so let your words be few." As a pastor, that's a challenging verse for me because I sort of live my whole life with words. I don't think anyone has ever accused me of being a man of few words. And so that passage where it says, "Let your words be few," is kind of a challenge to me. But I don't think the passage is trying to indicate so much that we're saying too many words. I think the passage is telling us that we might be saying the wrong words or at the wrong time. You know, there are some times when I actually become speechless, when I'm staring out at the Pacific Ocean, or when I'm looking at a sunset, or when I'm just in the middle of a forest. It's at those times that my words can actually become few. But I don't think Solomon is trying to tell us that we're using too many words. I think he's trying to draw a contrast between the words we usually speak and the words we should speak. You know, sometimes the words we speak are words of praise. The ocean is so powerful. The sunset is so vibrant. The forest is so tranquil. But sometimes the words we speak are words of criticism. The ocean is so cold. The sunset is too bright. The glare is blinding me off my television. Or maybe the forest is just too filled with bugs. But Jesus' words remind us that God is the one who is most worthy of our praise. And really, God is only worthy of our praise. To say hallowed be your name means that he is the only one we praise and that his name is worthy of praise. We use our words so much for criticism or for praise, for admiration or revulsion. And I think what Jesus is trying to draw our attention to is the fact that our opinions are neither here nor there when it comes to God. Our opinions don't really matter when it comes to God. I imagine that there are some times in your life when you're thinking about God and he's disappointed you and you want to criticize the work that he's doing. Or I imagine there's times in your life, there certainly is in my life, when I'm thinking about all the other things that I could be praising or all the other things I could be admiring. And Jesus' words remind us that God is the one worthy of our praise and that God is only worthy of our praise. And part of our problem is that more often we think about the things of this world that are admirable, the more often we can get our opinion of God diluted. He's just another admirable thing. Or the more we focus our attention on the things of this world that are to be critiqued or questioned, the more we question or critique God. Today I want to ask you to join me in getting back to that place where we just say, hallowed be your name. Where we just say, God, your name is worthy of praise and only praise. And where we say, God, you are the only name that is worthy of our praise.